Hey everybody, what's going on? It's your boy Brian here playing Snake Pass on the Nintendo Switch. It's a brand new game that just came out and involves a snake and a little bird, and it's really cute and really fun. I downloaded it on the eShop for 20 bucks, and it's pretty fun so far. We're gonna start a new game because it's a new game and it's a new playthrough, or just at least at the very least a showcase. So Boulder's Realm Paradise Path is our first of our levels here. There's a couple levels per world, there's different worlds, and yeah, it's fun. So I actually saw this at PAX East 2017 when I went, and it looked really, 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 really good. It has a really cool art style, the concept is super cool. You play as a snake, and you have to gather these keystones, and the snake's name being Noodle. Just like a danger noodle, it being a snake, being the code name for the snake and the bird. Yeah. So it has a very, very colorful art style. It's super cool. The gate's stuck. Yeah, yeah. So it's a unique puzzle game. You play as a snake and you gotta solve the things. So ZR to move forward. I'm playing on the Switch. It's available for the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One and all that fancy schmancy stuff. I'm playing it on Switch because I like my Nintendo Switch and I want to keep playing. And it can be portable if I wanted it to. So, yeah, I saw it at PAX and it looked absolutely gorgeous. Just the art style was super, super cool, super colorful, and really reminds me, I'm sure this is a common thing people who play this game would say, is it reminds me a lot of Banjo and Kazooie in terms of the art style. It's just very bright. And compared to a lot of the other games on the eShop and the games that I'm quite frankly interested in, it's colorful enough to catch my interest and want me to play. So you get to capture these blue orb things here, you have to get the keystone back to where you want to get it, and that's the whole point of the game. And solving the puzzles and getting control of Noodle can sometimes be difficult from what I found. I've only played a couple of levels because I did want to showcase this in a video or two. So you move faster by going left or right, slithering just like a snake. And up, you hold A on the Switch to move upwards, and you can coil around all those different... Ooh, there's a coin. I didn't see that my first playthrough. So you go up here and you kind of... You can tighten yourself by holding the ZL button, moving forward. Oh, there we go. Oh, I got it. Cool. So, yeah, this is the whole game, and it's really fun. It's not something you would think you'd have a lot of trouble doing, but to solve the puzzles and navigate properly is harder than you might think. So then we have, I believe his name is Doodle. Doodle helping us get the keystone in place, and Noodle being the hero here. Just put our whole body inside of here. Levitate up, there we go. And into the light beam, Noodle, yay! It's all done. So I guess there's 5 coins, I only got 1. Creative coiling. Yeah, Paradise Path is complete. So we'll play like, you know, 3 levels here. We have our next one. I didn't see the name of it before I pressed okay, so. Oops! All these levels in the beginning are obviously super easy, but they get harder as you go along. But for 20 bucks, it's like, right now especially, with the Switch not having all too many games on it, at the time of this recording, that is, it's a fun game to add to your collection. Let's see. Let's go! Yay! All right, Noodle and Doodle. Let's see. So we got a coil around here. I've seen a lot of people having trouble with the controls with this stuff. Not because the controls are bad, but because they're bad at the game. So you would think you'd be really good at it, but not quite. Now, I'm not going to go for every single blue orb here, because I don't know what the point of it is. Like, I know in like Banjo and Kazooie, in all those other types of games, there might be a reason that you gather all the items and whatnot, but I'm not too set on getting every single little thing that I need to. So let's see, wrap yourself around the bamboo to climb up. I certainly will. Thank you, Doodle. Thank you, Doodle. Nope, that's not where I want you to go. There we go. Okay. And then what they haven't told you in the tutorial yet is if you use ZL, you know, the back left bumper, it'll make you tighter around the bamboo and stuff. So it'll help your case out greatly. Let's see. You kind of hold it intermittently to climb up. There we go. Now, it looks like... Oh, it's super easy to control. It's not super easy. So, I'm just a pro at it already. So if you think, oh, this is easy, this is dumb. It's not. It's really, really cool. And, like, it's a unique idea for a puzzle game. Like, I never would have thought having control of a snake and a bird as a sidekick would be... an interesting game at all, but it's actually kind of interesting, and it's a very pretty looking game. And to carry it on the go with you on the Switch is really cool as well. You don't get that on the PlayStation 4 or the Xbox One or whatever. So there's that. I mean, it could be mobile on PC if you play it on PC, but why would you do that? Why would you buy this on a PC? Like, it makes no sense. Why would you do that? No. This gate has all the keystones missing. Wow. Just completely not aware of where things are located. Oh, they're all right there. And bring them back to the gate. Oh, I will. Cool. So, oh, I missed that one. Get it. Come on. Come on. Here we go. There we go. Cool. So, I keep forgetting that you have to slither by going left and right. Left, right, left, right, left. Up. There we go. How about... Let's get the yellow one first. Why not? Come on. Wrap around and climb! Okay, Doodle. Okay. Let's go. Boom. Tighten yourself up there. There we go. Is something cool up here? Nope, nothing cool. Yay! Yellow keystone! Looks like one of the missing keys. Oh, really? I couldn't tell. There we go. Cheat the system! Yeah, cool. Let's go. I am making quick work of these levels. Once you master the controls, you'll still have some trouble. Like, you'll think you have it all mastered, but you don't. But I played this level 2 or 3 times just to get a good grip on what to do. Should I make it? I'm gonna make it! Ah! Yeah, I'm gonna make it. So, one thing to note, which I don't really like, is when you're playing the game and you fall into a pit or something, you have to restart the whole level. The whole everything. You need to restart everything. So keep that in mind. Don't fall. Don't die. There are no enemies in the game as far as we've gotten right now. There are no enemies, so don't worry about, like, actually dying. But if you fall off a ledge, you are not gonna be happy, so... That happened to me last night. I was gonna play, like, the whole first world. I was gonna play the whole entire first world. And then I was like, you know, I fell. I'm like, nope, not doing it. I'm not doing it. Okay, coil around here. You have to be super careful once you're coiling around above a not safe area, like the pit of death right there. I'll go get that one, and then we'll call it for this level. Oh, flying snake! That'd be cool if you eventually got wings, but that would make no sense in context of the game, so... I don't anticipate that being any DLC of any kind. So, looks like I'm good with missing only 3 of them. That's fine. And you can obviously come back into the levels and complete everything if you want to, just to go completely completionist, but... Again, not a goal I necessarily... aspire to, so, or aspire to. Hey, you guys are lucky. I could be making a lot of snake puns right now, and I could be making terrible jokes, but I'm not, because I am considerate of the people, and their needs, and there we go. So Gatekeeper Gardens is the next level. This may be our final level we cover for today. I just want you to get you just a gist of what the game is like. Maybe I'll continue doing some more videos on this if it is fun, which it is. So, we'll see. But did you know Noodle is a vegetarian? That's a lie. Snakes are not vegetarians. Sun shining? Check. Wind blowing? Check. Birds, sing! Oh. What's that? What? What was that? What was that? You remove the keystones and close the gate. Oh, there's a bigger mystery on our hands. See? Yeah, see? Okay. Is there anything up here? Looks like no. It's just there for no reason. Okay. Tighten your grip. Yep. Yep, I know. Go. Go. Okay. A common complaint I've also heard about this game is that it's a bit of a pain to hold down, or you shouldn't have to hold down, like, ZL the whole time to move. I don't mind that. That's, like, one of the bigger... hold on. Coil. 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 Go! Yeah, there we go. That's another common complaint that I've heard, only from a few people. There's not too many people playing this game right now. I like it. It's cool. And it, what really did it was seeing it at PAX East, not even other people playing it. I just really like the art style. Can I make it? Can I make it? Can I make it? Ooh, so close! He takes no fall damage, too, so keep that in mind when you're playing here. I get another coin. I love that you can navigate the level super easy if you really wanted to. Like, the physics in the game are kind of weird. Like, okay, now I'm just a flying snake. It's cool. Let's see. Over here. Boom. Coil! Coil! Coil noodle, coil! Up! 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 Use your neck! Use your neck! There we go. There we go. Give me that bubble! Give me that bubble! Give me the bubble! And if you really get stuck, yeah, see, so Doodle will actually give you a little lift. Oh, I thought that was a pit of darkness. If you get stuck, he can give you a lift. It doesn't help when you're about to fall off the map, so don't think like, oh, he'll save me. No, he won't. He's not strong enough to carry you, clearly, because you're a giant snake, and that's just a small bird. So keep that in mind. Don't fall off the ledge. Just don't do it. Just really, just don't. I know I already said that, but really don't. Okay, back up here. So you can breeze through these levels kind of quickly if you really wanted to. I just said that earlier. Because the keystones are all kind of... They're not close. But if you're going for just the keystones, then... Is this a checkpoint? I don't want to fall off the map and risk it, but I feel like that's a checkpoint. Yay, there's a little slide. Oh, that's so cool. Yay, slide. And I think he can breathe underwater too, which is weird. But again, I'm not complaining, but it's just weird. There we go. So your easiest time is going to be getting these blue orbs here. Did we get all three? I think we got all three. We go up here. We'll get this. Boom. Okay. We'll get two more. Where's two more I can get? Over here. But see, the whole point is to explore and to go through and beat the levels and collect all the collectibles. It's just like Banjo-Kazooie in that sense, where there's a bunch of collectibles that maybe you have to get for a particular reason, maybe you don't, but there's still a bunch of them for you to get. And it's very fitting with Yooka-Laylee coming out very soon at the time of this recording. It may be already out. You may be able to view it now. But it's very timely because it is another really bright, colorful, creative platformer type game. So that will be fun to play as well. I believe we have all the keystones. Let's get out of this, below this popsicle stand here. Let's see. We have the green keystone. We have the yellow keystone. We have the pink keystone. Oh, there's another orb behind there. I should grab that. Grab the orb. Back here. Go. Go. Yes. All right, we're only missing four. We missed three last time. We're missing four this time. Just to show you the point. You know, I don't want to spoil the whole thing for you. Like, none of them are hard to find. Like, if you explore the level enough, you'll be able to find them just fine. All three keystones, we have three of the little blue orbs missing, two coins. We're rich. We're rich. We're rich. Okay, so it seems like there's only one more level left. Baldur's Realm Creeping Causeway. I'm going to play it. Because why not? I'm not going to leave it for a separate video. That'd be dumb. So, slither left and right to build up. Who were the previous inhabitants of Haven Tor? I don't know. I'm a snake. I'm not self-aware. Like, or maybe he is. I don't know. Maybe he knows his existence as a snake. That's one thing. It's like, do snakes ever realize, like, hey, I'm a snake? Like, do they have thoughts? I don't know. I know dolphins have thoughts. But this game would be a lot different if it were based on dolphins. I don't think that's the case. But, like, I wonder if, like, not Noodle in particular, but if snakes know, like, hey, I'm slithering, and I know it's a slither left and right to go faster, you know, I wonder if that ever crosses their mind. Can you tell I'm really tired? Like, here Brian is questioning the existential meaning of snakes in the world. Yep, that's it. I'm not even tired. No, I'm good. I'm good, fam. I'm good. This could be bad. 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 Yeah, it's bad. See, I told you, don't fall. Now we go from the beginning. Yay. And I thought we activated a checkpoint up here. No? So, sometimes it's worth it. Sometimes it's not. I wouldn't risk it if I were you. Let's see. Go up here. Boom. One. Do this again. Two. Yeah, I activated this thing up here. Three. There we go. One more up here. So, oh no, I did not activate a checkpoint. Okay. So, make sure you activate a checkpoint before you do something super crazy. Okay. That should be activated. Now, if I die, do I respawn from the checkpoint? Let's see. Can confirm I do. Okay, cool. But do we still have the other collectibles we have? That's the main question. I don't care about if I die and whatever. You know, I care if there's collectibles still missing, then it kind of defeats the point. So let's see. Slither, slither, slither. Up here. Yep. Uh-huh, yep, I get it, yep, yep, yep. Is there anything up here? Really? There's no orbs up here? Wow, okay, there's an orb. Cool, there we go. Boom, made it, okay. Okay, so it does save our progress with the orbs, okay, that's good. So there are checkpoints, my mistake. I thought they weren't, or they didn't quite work the way you wanted them to. Here we go. Up here. Coil around this one. Oh, I got it. Cool. I don't care. I got it. So where are the other ones? Where are the other keystones? Where are they? Slither. There we go. Slither, slither, slither. I'm hungry. I need to get food. You might be able to hear my stomach rumbling. Probably not. No, because the game audio overshadows my grumbling stomach. So, okay. I'm hungry for some keystones. That's what I'm hungry for. Yeah, that's it. That's how you tie it back into the game. Here we go. There must be one way up here. There must be. Okay. Now I'm having a little bit of trouble. There's definitely one up there. Okay. But the controls are still... Oh, they're still fine. Here we go. Up. I keep saying here we go a lot. Go. Nope, I messed up. Okay. Oh, look at that. Flawless slip. Nope, nope. The second I say flawless, I get it flawed. Okay. Up. Up. Why am I messing up the controls now? Why am I messing them up now? Like, all of a sudden, I'm like, how do I play? What? Okay. Up. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. Good noodle. You're such a good noodle. You're such a good noodle. Such a... No, 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 no. Give me a lift. Give me a lift. Give me a lift. Ah, there we go. Cool. So that's a situation where doodle actually helps. Come on. There it is. Boom. Look at that. Okay. Pinky stone. Oh, no, 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 help, 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 help. Nope, I'm falling. I'm falling. No, it's fine. I get it. It's fine. Okay. Let's go up here. This way. I'll coil around here a little bit. It'd be cool if you actually got bigger if you collected those blue things. Pieces of water. I'm falling. Yeah, I'm falling. Okay. Coil. And now we coil here. Lift me up. Lift me up before you go, go. Okay. Tighten, tighten, tighten. It's not tightening. He's not tightening. No. Okay. Now this is where it gets difficult, right? Now this is it. Here we go. Up. 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 Nope. Nope. Okay. Oops. Alright, there we go. Okay. That took a little bit, but we got it. Oh, and thankfully the keystone's right up here. We got a lot less of the blue orbs, but that's okay. There we go. Cool. Where is the gate? Where's the gate? The gate is over there. Back over there. Okay. Just slither along here. Get ourselves another blue water orb. Mystical blue water magical orb. I'm gonna get that coin. Give me that coin. Ooh, that's a gap. Oh, go! Go, 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 go! There we go. Now, easy coil up here. It's easy peasy. Easy peasy. Here we go. Here we go. Boom. There it is. Okay. Little bit of trouble going up that area, but it wasn't it wasn't frustrating. It was difficult, not that's two separate things about games. It's like, if it's frustrating, then that's just aggravating, and that's just like, okay, this is just not my thing. Ooh, is it a cutscene? Is it a cutscene? What's this? Every beast slithers, skitters, or crawls. In your debt. Is in your debt. Take this as our thanks. Of what? What does that do? What does it do? I'll take what does it do for 500, Alex? Alec? Whatever? Alex Trebek. Alec. It's not Alec Trebek. It's Alex Trebek. Creative coiling. Okay. Didn't tell us what it did, but oh well. So I'm gonna end the video off here. You got a good idea for Snake Pass. You can get it on the Nintendo eShop. 20 bucks and it's all yours. Anyways, I wanna thank you guys and girls for listening and watching to this small demonstration video. I hope you have a fantastic day. Maybe I'll come back and do World 2. Who knows? Have a good day. Bye.